A very good morning, children. In the last class, I had completed part 2 of chapter 7, that is Glimpses of India. And part 2 was Coorg. We came to know about a very beautiful destination place, Coorg. And today, let's proceed with the third part of the same chapter from your first flight book, that is Tea from Assam by Arup Kumar Datta. Okay, so from the name itself, it's very clear, children. Today we will get some information about the tea plantations from Assam. So coming to your book, be with me and try to understand the chapter thoroughly. Tea from Assam. Before starting the chapter, let me introduce a little bit that there are two main characters in this chapter, Pranjol and Rajveer. Both are the classmates at a school in Delhi, okay? And here, through their conversation in this chapter, we will get to know some interesting facts and myths associated with tea, okay? So coming to the chapter, Pranjol, a youngster from Assam, is Rajveer's classmate at school in Delhi. Pranjol's father is the manager of a tea garden in Upper Assam, and Pranjol has invited Rajveer to visit his home during the summer vacation. So from here we came to know that Pranjol, he belonged to Assam, and he had come to Delhi for his study purpose, where Rajveer was his classmate and his best friend. And Pranjol's father, he is the manager of a tea garden in Upper Assam. And Pranjol here invited his friend Rajveer to visit his home, that is to Assam, during the summer vacation. Okay, so here we will come to know that now both of them, they are traveling to Assam in a train, and what all happens there. Okay. Chai garam, garam chai, a vendor called out in a high-pitched voice. He came up to the window and asked, "Chai saab, give us 2 cups, Pranjol said. They sipped the steaming hot liquid. Almost everyone in their compartment was drinking tea too. Do you know that over 80 crore cups of tea are drunk every day throughout the world? Rajveer said. So, as I told you, now they both are in the train moving to Assam, because Pranjol had invited Rajveer to visit his hometown. So here, when they are in the train, they heard a vendor means the seller. He was selling in a high pitched, in a loud sound. He was saying chai garam, as this scene is very common when you go by a train. Okay. And many of you might be recalling your past journeys, I hope so. So, that seller, the tea seller, he came to their window, to their compartment, and asked them that, do you need chai, that is tea? So, Pranjol answered him that, yeah, give us 2 cups tea. And they both started sipping. Sipping means, to sip the tea and take the taste. And the tea was very hot, that it was full of steam, okay? And almost everyone in that compartment, they were also drinking tea. So Rajveer said at once that, to whom? To Pranjol, that do you know, because he's just sharing his knowledge what he had over here. He's saying that, do you know that 80 crores cups of tea are drunk every day throughout the world? It's really in a very big number. So it's very popular in the world, what? The tea. Because most of the people, they love drinking tea. Next, view, exclaimed Pranjol. Tea really is very popular. View is just an expression given over here by Pranjol, okay? So he said, really, tea is very popular all over the world and people like to have it. The train pulled out of the station. Pranjol buried his nose in his detective book again. Rajveer too was an ardent fan of detective stories, but at the moment he was keener on looking at the beautiful scenery. So now pulled out means came out of the station. Now the train had left the station, and now after having the cups of tea, Pranjal again buried his nose here, means he again was busy reading one of the detective book. Okay, a detective, you know very well, one who examines the crimes. So he was interested in reading that book again. And Rajveer too was an ardent means strong fan of the detective stories. Okay, but at that moment he was keener means very much here. Okay, he was very much interested on looking at the beautiful scenery, the very greenery outside, which he had never seen before. It was green everywhere. Rajveer had never seen so much greenery before. Then the soft green paddy fields gave way to tea bushes. So what Rajveer was enjoying, the beautiful green scenery outside from his window, and it was green everywhere. Wherever his eyes goes, he could see the greenery everywhere. And Rajveer, he had never seen so. You came to know that why he had never seen? Yeah, because he was staying in Delhi, and you know, in Delhi we will not find the fields and all the greeneries over there. Okay, because everywhere only you will find the buildings and apartments and everything. Okay, that's why. And now as the train was going on moving, the soft green paddy fields, the fields where the wheat was grown, it had passed away, and now he could see the tea bushes grown over in the fields. It was a magnificent view. Against the backdrop of densely wooded hills, a sea of tea bushes stretched as far as the eye could see, dwarfing the tiny tea plants were tall, sturdy shade trees, and amidst the orderly rows of bushes busily moved doll-like figures. Now really the view outside was very beautiful, magnificent means it was so beautiful scene. Okay, and against the backdrop means at the background, okay, of the densely wooded hills, at the background of those wooded hills. Okay, wooded hills means the thickly covered forest with trees. The hills were fully covered, densely covered with trees. Okay, so the in the background what he could see, that the hills, it were covered, densely wooded hills, a sea of tea bushes stretched. Okay, there were the thickly covered, these hills were covered with trees, and he could see the tea bushes. Okay, the tea plantation, it was spread as far as the eye could see. Over those hills he could see the tea plantation, okay, which was spread over the whole area as far as his eyes could see. Dwarfing means making short. Okay, dwarf, you know, the short creature. So the dwarfing means making short. The tiny tea plants were the tall sturdy shade trees, means there were the sturdy means very strong trees, where amidst the in the middle of this row of bushes of tea plantation, there was tea plantation. Okay, the fields were fully covered with tea bushes, but in the middle of those fields there were the strong trees which were giving shade to it. Okay, and the in between the rows of those tea plantation could be seen the busily moved doll-like figures. Who are these doll-like figures? Yeah, they are the tea pluckers. You might have seen the always in these tea plantation fields, the women are always busy plucking the leaves of that tea bushes, isn't it, from the tea bushes. So these doll-like figures, they could be seen. Okay, now he was seeing from where? From the train. So the women were seen like the doll-like figures. Okay, Now, in the distance was an ugly building with smoke blowing out of tall chimneys. Hey, a tea garden, Rajveer cried excitedly. Ranjol, who had been born and brought up on a plantation, didn't share Rajveer's excitement. Okay, so in little bit distance, he could also see an ugly building, very dirty building was there, with smoke coming out of the chimneys. Chimneys, you know very well, nowadays in the kitchen also you may see the chimney, which is used to remove the smoke, okay, from the that particular area. So he could find a very dirty building from where the smoke was coming out. Okay, blowing out means coming out of the tall chimneys were there. So Rajveer, he cried means he just with excitement in a loud voice he said, when he saw the tea garden there, that hey, see that tea garden. So Pranjal, who had been born and brought up on a plantation, as we came to know, Pranjal was from Assam only. So he was born there only, and he was brought up, his whole childhood was spent there, okay, on that in the place of that tea plantation. He didn't share Rajveer's excitement. He was not that much excited seeing Rajveer's excitement, because it was very common for him. From the childhood onwards, he had seen, okay, everywhere the tea garden near him. Oh, this is a tea country now, he said. Assam has the largest concentration of plantations in the world. You will see enough gardens to last your lifetime. So seeing the Rajveer's excitement, what Pranjal said, that yeah, this is a tea country. This country is known as the tea country because everywhere you will see the tea plantations here. And one more thing he shared with Rajveer, that Assam has the largest concentration. Concentration means large number of plantations of tea in the world. And he also added that that he will never, okay, see in his lifetime that many enough gardens he will get to see here in Assam, that he will never forget in his lifetime. Okay, I have been reading as much as I could about tea, Rajveer said. No one really knows who discovered tea, but there are many legends. What legends? So what Rajveer told to Pranjal, that he had been reading, because he was going to visit Assam, so he thought that let him have some knowledge about that place. So he was reading about the tea and all, and he said that really no one knows that who actually discovered this tea, but he said that there are many legends. Legends are the mythical stories, okay, which are handed from one generation to another. We are going on listening some stories, okay. So that is only, so there are the stories related to these tea gardens also. So Pranjal just asked, what legends you are talking about? Let me also know what stories you know. So Rajveer again started sharing one of the story. Well, there's the one about the Chinese emperor who always boiled water before drinking it. One day a few leaves of the twigs burning under the pot fell into the water, giving it a delicious flavor. It is said they were tea leaves. So what was the one story that Rajveer shared with Pranjal? That once there was a Chinese emperor, one Chinese king, his habit was always to boil the water before drinking it. Okay, so one day what happened, while he was boiling the water, so how he used to boil on the firewood. Okay, so one day while he was boiling the water, so few leaves of the twigs means the branches, okay, which were burning under the pot, it fell into the water, inside the water it fell, and after that when he drank, it was really tasty. Okay, so it is said that they were only the tea leaves. Tell me another, scoffed Pranjal. So, scoffed means laughed. Pranjal couldn't digest this story because it was so funny. Okay, so he said, okay, now tell me another story. What you know about this tea? We have an Indian legend too. Bodhidharma, an ancient Buddhist ascetic, cut off his eyelids because he felt sleepy during meditations. 10 tea plants grew out of the eyelids. The leaves of these plants, when put in hot water and drunk, banished sleep. So he said another story is from our country. Okay, one Indian story is there that an ancient Buddhist ascetic. Ascetic means monk. One Buddhist monk whose name was Bodhidharma. Okay, what he did while doing the meditations. Okay, meditations means while he was in deep thoughts, closing his eyes when he was sitting there, he felt sleepy. And that's why what he did, he cut off his eyelids. Eyelids are the eye covers, you know. So he cut off it. Okay, why? So that he should not feel sleepy again during the meditations. And what happened then? 10 tea plants grew out of the eyelids. Wherever those eyelids fell, from there the tea plants grew. Okay, and the leaves of these plants, when put in hot water and drunk, banished the sleep. And when these leaves from these plants, when they were put in the hot water and boiled and drunk, it banished the sleep. Means it exiled the sleep. It took the sleep away. Tea was first drunk in China, Rajveer added, as far back as 2700 BC. In fact, words such as tea, chai and chini are from Chinese. Tea came to Europe only in the 16th century and was drunk more as medicine than as beverage. So Rajveer further added, because as we came to know, he had collected a good knowledge about the tea before visiting Assam. So two stories he told about the discovery of the tea, and now he is telling that tea was first drunk in China only, that also when in 2700 BC. Okay, and all these words which are used like tea, chai, chini, all these are the Chinese words. Okay, and this tea came to Europe in 16th century, that also it was drunk more as medicine than the beverages. Beverage means the hot drinks. Anything apart from medicine is, you know very well, it is used to cure some diseases. Okay, and beverages means all the hot drinks are the beverages. So it was drunk more as medicine in the beginning than as the beverage. The train clattered into Mariani Junction. The boys collected their luggage and pushed their way to the crowded platform. Pranjal's parents were waiting for them. Soon they were driving towards Dekiabari, the tea garden managed by Pranjal's father. Now, clattered means to make a clattering sound. Okay, so when the train was going to stop at the Mariani Junction, the train, it made out a clattering sound. You also know well, children, those who had traveled by train, how it stops making the sound. And the boys, both the boys, Pranjal and Rajveer, they started collecting their luggage. Okay, and they pushed their way to the crowded platform. The platform was very crowded. There were many people, and they made their way. And outside there, Pranjal's parents were waiting for them. Okay. To take them home, and soon they were driving towards the Dekiabari. It is the place where the tea gardens were managed by Pranjal's father. In the beginning we came to know he was the manager in one of the tea plantation. So that place is Dekiabari. An hour later, the car veered sharply off the main road. They crossed a cattle bridge and entered Dekiabari tea estate. Okay, so it took a complete 1 hour. The car veered sharply off means moved at once. Okay, from where it moved at once, it moved off to the main road, and they crossed a cattle bridge over there. One bridge was there, and they entered to Dekiabari tea estate. Saket, where the tea plantation was there. On both sides of the gravel road were acre upon acre of tea bushes, all neatly pruned to the same height. Groups of tea pluckers with bamboo baskets on their backs, wearing plastic aprons, were plucking the newly sprouted leaves. So after reaching to this place Dhekiabari, where there were the tea plantations, tea fields everywhere, after reaching there, what they saw? On both the sides of the gravel road means the road which is covered with sandstone, okay? So on both the sides of the roads, there were acres and acres of the tea bushes there, okay? Acres, the land, the fields are measured in this way only, acres, okay? So the complete fields could be seen covered with tea bushes. And all neatly pruned means cut. And all these bushes, they were cut to the same height. When you will visit Assam, you will find really a very magnificent, beautiful scenery, that all the bushes you will find in the same height over there. And the groups of the tea pluckers, mostly the women used to pluck the leaves there, they have the bamboo baskets on their backs. They carry the bamboo baskets and they have to wear the plastic aprons. Aprons are the outer dress, you know. The aprons are being worn in the kitchen also. When the mummy used to cook food, they used to wear apron, okay? That is the outer dress. So they hang the bamboo baskets on their backs and then they wear the plastic aprons. And they were plucking the newly sprouted leaves. Okay, sprouted means newly grown leaves. They were just plucking, taking away from the bushes. Pranjal's father slowed down to allow a tractor pulling a trailer load of tea leaves to pass. This is the second flush or sprouting period, isn't it, Mr. Bedwa? Rajir asked. It lasts from May to July and yields the best tea. So now, Pranjal's father, just he was moving, okay, where? Through that road. And now, we just slowed down to allow a tractor, okay, which was fully loaded with the tea leaves. So, he allowed the tractor to pass and he gave the sight. This is the second flush. So, here, Rajveer again, he had gained too much knowledge about that tea plantations. So he just said, Mr. Barua. Who is Mr. Barua? Pranjal's father. Okay. So this is the second flush means this is the sprouting period, isn't it? So I think the tea is growing here second time now. As he said that he knows that the tea, it lasts from May to July. Okay, means we can get the best tea from the month of May to July and yields the best tea, and that time only the this tea bushes, it gives out the best tea. Okay, you seem to have done your homework before coming, Pranjal's father said in surprise. So Pranjal's father was really surprised and happy too, and he said, commenting that it seems that Rajveer had done his homework. Homework means he had gained a complete knowledge before coming to that place. So he had enough knowledge about the period of the best yielding of tea plantations and everything. Okay, yes, Mr. Barua, Rajveer admitted, but I hope to learn much more while I am here. So Rajveer admitted, he accepted that yes, he had prepared a lot, he had read many books and got the knowledge about this tea plantations and all, and but he further says that he wants to learn much more till he is in that place, okay, in Assam. And he was enjoying his summer vacation there at his friend's house in Assam. So really, it's a very beautiful place. Whenever you would get an opportunity to visit, try to visit the place and enjoy the beautiful green tea plantations in Assam, okay? So here I come to the end of this chapter. So goodbye children, till the next chapter, and have a good day.